Hello friends, welcome to my channel. I am Kumar. So today I am going to explain about that is the 9th standard social second chapter, the Vedic age around 1500 BC to 600 to 1500 BC. So in the previous lessons you have learnt about the Harappan civilization, how the Harappa lived in cities in your first chapter, and had a well organized trade and craft activities the Harappan civilization had, and they also had a script which we have been so far not able to decipher. However, around 1900 BC, these cities began to decline, and a number of rural settlements were appeared in the city, and these rural settlements show some of the certain Harappan elements. It also shows around the same time we find archaeological evidence of the arrival of some new people. They are known as the Aryans or Indo-Aryans on the outskirts of the Harappan region. We can see in our archaeological evidence. In the present lesson, we shall study the circumstances under which these new people arrived and also learn about the main features of their culture, as despite in literature they are called as the Vedas. What is Vedas? The word Veda that is derived from the root word with, which means to know. The word Veda means the sacred knowledge contained in the text, to know some of the Vedic text. So two categories of text that includes the corpus of the Vedic culture, these are the mantra and brahmana. The mantra category forms the core of the Vedic texts and has four separate collections. These are the Rigveda, Samveda, Yajurveda and the Atharva Veda. The Brahmas not be confused with Brahminical class or prose text containing the explanation of the mantras as well as the sacrificial rituals. The four Vedas together with their Brahmas, they are known as the Shruti or hearing, that which was directly heard by the sages and the Aranyakas, the literature, forest, treatises and the Upanishads sitting down beside, are mainly appended to the Brahmanas, and these are also known as the Vedanta, the end of Veda, and containing some of the physiological discussion. The Rig Veda, it is the collection of 1028 hymens that were divided in 10 mandalas, and they are the earliest composition and hence depict the life of the early Vedic people in India. They tell the Samveda, it is the collection of verses mostly taken from, it is taken from Rig Veda but arranged in a poetic form of facilitating singing. The Yajurveda, that is found in two recensions, black and white, they are full of rituals that are performed publicly or individually. The Atharva Veda is a collection of magical spells and charms to ward off evil spirits and diseases. So careful studies have shown that the Vedic texts reflect two stages of development in terms of literature as well as social and cultural evolution. The Rig Veda, which is the oldest Vedic text that reflects one stage of social and cultural development, whereas the other three Vedas reflect another stage. The first stage is known as the Rig Vedic period and the early Vedic period, and the later stage is known as the later Vedic period. The age of the early Vedic period corresponds with the date of composition of Rig Veda hymns, and this date has been fixed between 2500 to 2500 BC, and the later Vedic period is placed between 600 to 1000 BC. Recently, the Rig Veda has been included to UNESCO as the list of literature significant world human heritage. Next, migration of the Aryans. The authority of the Vedic hymns were the Aryans, but in the 19th century Aryans were considered as Aryans, and now it is thought of as a linguistic group of people who spoke Indo-European language, from which later emerged the Sanskrit, Latin and Greek, and many other languages found with the help of that, and this is reflected from the works in these languages which are similar in sound and meaning. Thus, the Sanskrit words matri and pitri are similar to Latin mater and pater. Similarly, the inner of the Hittite, that is the Turkey language, is similar to the Indra of Vedas, and Suryas and Marutas of Kassite, Mesopotamia. Is inscriptions are equivalent of the Vedic Surya and Marut. Originally, the Aryan seems to have lived somewhere in the steppes stretching from southern Russia to central Asia. From here, a group of them migrated to northwest India and came to be known as Indo-Aryans or just Aryans. The archaeological evidence of migration comes from archaeological evidence of the migration comes from what is known as the Andronovan culture, that is situated in South Siberia. This culture flourished in the second millennium BC. The people moved to north of Hindu Kush, and from here they entered India. During the period 500 to 1900 BC, we get in this region evidence of horses, spoked wheel, fire cult and cremation, which were formed important part of the Aryan's life in India. Apart from these, the artifacts and ceramics also suggest the movements of people from Central Asian region to South Asia region. However, it may be noted that some scholars still argue that the Aryans were the indigenous people of India, and that they did not come from outside. They did not come from any other place. The new people came in several batches spanning several hundred years. All this while interaction between the indigenous inhabitants and the newcomers continued. One of the important results of this process of interaction was that the Vedic from the Aryan language became prominent in the entire northwest India, and the text composed in this language, as mentioned, are popularly known as the Vedic texts. Next, the geographical origin of the Vedic Aryans. The early Vedic Aryans, they lived in the area that are known as the Sapta Sindhu, meaning of seven rivers. This area large covers the northwestern part of the South Asia up to the river Yamuna. The seven rivers, including Sindhu, Vitasa, that is Jhelum, Asikni, that is Chenab, Parushni, that is Ravi, and the Vipash, that is Bees, and Shutudri, that is Satlaj, and the Saras, and the Saraswati. And in this area of Rigvedic, people lived, fought battles, grazed their herds of cattle and other domestic animals. Gradually moving eastwards, they came to occupy eastern UP, that is Kosal, North Vihar, that is Veda, during the later Vedic period. Early Vedic economy. The early Vedic Aryans were pastoralistic. Lasts cattle rearing was their main occupation. They reared cattle like sheep, goats and horses for purpose of milk, meat and hide. And we arrive at this conclusion after analyzing the literal evidence in the Rig Veda. A large number of words are derived from the word go, meaning cow. A wealthy person was known as Kumat, and the daughter called Dulhitri, which means one who milks the cow. The word Gaveshana literally means search for cow, but it also means battle, since many battles were fought over cattle. The cows were thought of as providers of everything. Prayers are offered for increase in the number of cattle. All the above and many more references shows that the cattle breed was more important for Rigvedic Aryans. Next is, however, this not suggests that the very early Vedic people had no knowledge of agriculture. The evidence for agriculture in comparison with pastoral activities in the early portion is merger and mostly late insertion. A few references show that they had knowledge of agriculture and practiced it to supplement their food requirement, and they produced yawa, modern jaw and barley, which was rather a generic word of cereals. Apart from cattle rearing and small scale cultivation, the Rig Vedic people also engaged in many other economic activities like hunting, carpentry, tanning, weaving, chariot making, metals, smeltery, etc. Where some such activities they were doing, and the products of these activities were exchanged through barter system they were using. And however, cows were the most favored medium of exchange, and the priest received cows, horses and gold ornaments as fees of their performing sacrifice. Next, after this, the changes in the later Vedic phase. During later Vedic phase, agriculture became the mainstay of the Vedic people. Many rituals were introduced to initiate the process of agriculture. It also speak of plogging with yokes of 6 and 8 oxen. The buffalo had been domesticated for the agriculture purpose. This animal was extremely useful for plogging the swampy land, and the god Indra acquires a new epithet, lord of plog, in this during the Rigvedic period. And the number of varieties of plants food increased. Apart from barley, people started cultivating wheat, rice, pulses, lentils, millet, sugarcane, many other things. The items of dana and dakshini included cooked rice. Thus, with the beginning of food production, agriculture produce began to be offered in the ritual, and tila, from which the first widely used vegetable food oil was delivered, increasingly came to be used in rituals. The main factor in the expansion of the Aryan culture during the later Vedic period was in the beginning of the use of iron in the around 1000 BC. The Rigvedic people, they knew of all the of a metal that called ayas, which was either copper or bronze. In the later Vedic literature, ayas was qualified with shama or krishna, meaning black, or to denote iron. Archaeological archaeology has shown that iron began to be used around 1000 BC, which is also the period of later Vedic literature. The northern and eastern parts of India to which the Aryans later migrated, they received more rainfall than the northwestern part of India. As a result, the region is covered with thick rainforest which could not be cleared by copper or stone tools used by Rigvedic people. The use of iron tool now helped people clear the dense rainforest, particularly the huge stumps left after burning, in a more effective manner. Large tracts of forest lands could be converted into cultivated pieces in relatively lesser time. In the Rigvedic, and there has been a continuous increase in the population during the later Vedic period due to the expansion of economy based on their agriculture. The increased number and size of painted grayware PGW settlements in the Dobe area shows this. With the passage of time, the Vedic people, they acquired better knowledge of seasons, manuring and irrigation, and all these developments resulted in the substantial enlargement of certain settlements such as Hastinapur, Kaushambi towards the end of the later Vedic period, and these settlements slowly began to acquire characters of towns. Such rudimentary towns inhabited mainly by chiefs, princes, priests and artisans were supported by peasants who could spare them for some part of their produce, voluntary or involuntary. Early Vedic society. So, the family was the basic unit of Rig Vedic society. It was patriarchal in nature. Monogamy was the usual norm of marriage, but the chiefs at the time practiced polygamy. Marriage took place after attaining maturity. After marriage, the wife went to her husband's house. The family was part of large grouping called as vis or clan. One or more than one clans made jana or tribe. The jana was the largest social unit. All the members of a clan were related to each other by blood relationship, and the members of the tribe was based on the birth and not on residence in a certain area. Thus, the members of the Bharata tribe were known as Bharatas. It did not imply any territory. The Rig Vedic society was a simple and largely an egalitarian society. There was no caste division. Occupation was not based on birth. Members of a family could adopt different occupation. However, certain differences did exist during the period. Varna and color was a basic of initial differentiation between the Vedic and non-Vedic people. The Vedic people were fair, whereas non-Vedic indigenous people were dark in complexion and spoke a different language. Thus, Rig Vedic mentions Arya Varna and Dasa Varna. Here, Dasa has been used in the sense of grouping different people from the Rig Vedic people. Later, Dasa came to mean the slaves. The warriors, priests and the ordinary peoples were the three sections of Rig Vedic tribe. The Sudra characters came into existence only towards the end of the Rig Vedic period, and this means that the divisions of the society in the early Vedic period was not stopped. This is indicated by the following verse in Rig Veda. I am a poet, my father is physician, and my mother grinds grain upon the stone. Streaming for wealth with varied plans, we follow our desires like cattle. The woman in society enjoyed respectable position. She was married at a proper age and could choose a husband for her own choice. She could take part in the proceedings of tribal assembles called Sambha and Samiti. After this, social changes in the later Vedic phase. The family remains the basic unit of the Vedic society, however, its composition underwent a change. The later Vedic family became large enough to be called as a joint family, with three or four generations living together. The rules of hearts discovered at Atranjikhira and the Ahichahatra show that these were meant for communal feeding or food, for cooking of food or for large family. And the institutions of Gotra developed in this period. This means that people having common Gotra, descent from a common ancestor, and no marriage between the members of the same Gotra could take place. Monogamous marriages were preferred, even though polygamy was frequent. Some restrictions on women appear during this period. In a text, women have been counted as wives along with dates and wine. In another text, a daughter has been said to be the source of all sorrows. Women had to stay with their husband at his place after marriage. The participation of women in public meeting was restricted. The most important change was the rise and growth of social differentiation in the form of varna system. The four varnas in which the society came into to be divided were the Brahmanas, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Shudras. The growing numbers of the sacrifice and rituals during the period of made Brahmanas very powerful. They conducted various rituals, including those related to different stages of agricultural operation. This made them all more important. The Kshatriyas, next in the social hierarchy, were the rulers. They, along with the Brahmanas, controlled all the aspects of life. The Vaishyas, the most numerous varna, were engaged in agriculture as well as in the trade and artisanal activities. The Brahmanas and the Kshatriyas were dependent on the tributes paid to them by the Vaishyas. The Shudras, the fourth varna, were at the bottom of the social hierarchy, and they were ordained to be in servants of three upper varnas. Next, another important institution that began to take shape was ashrama, or different stages of life. Brahmacharya, student life; Grihastha, householder; and Vanaprastha, hermitage, stages are mentioned in the text. Later, Sannyas, the fourth stage, also came to be added. Together with Varna, it came to know as Varna Ashrama Dharma. The early Vedic religion, the prayers to propitiate gods for physical protection and for material gains, were the main concern of the Rig Vedic people. The Rig Vedic gods were generally personifications of different aspects of natural forces such as rain, storms, sun, etc. The attributes of these gods also reflect the tribal and patriarchal nature of the society, as we do not find many goddesses mentioned in the text. Indra, Agni, Varuna, Mitra, Dhyas, Pushana, Yama, Soma, etc. are all male gods. In comparison, we have only few goddesses such as Usha, Saraswati, Prithvi, etc., which occupy second position in the pantheon. The function of different gods reflect their need in the society. Thus, since the Rig Vedic people were engaged in wars with each other, they worshipped Indra as god. He is the most frequently mentioned god in the Rig Veda. He carried the thunderbolt and was also respected as a weather god who brought rain. Maruts, the god of storm, aided Indra in the wars in the way tribesmen aided their leaders in the tribal wars. Agni, the fire god, was the god of home and was considered as intermediary between god and men. Soma was associated with plants and herbs. Soma was also a plant from which an intoxicating juice was extracted. The Chiefs choose was drunk at sacrifices, for no another important deity was the keeper of the cosmic order known as Ritha. This Ritha was an important aspect of tribal setup. Pushan was god of roads, herdsmen and cattle in the life of the pastoral nomads. This god must be very important, and other gods were similarly associated with other aspects of natural and life. All these gods were invoked and propitiated at yajnas or sacrifice, and the sacrifice were organized by the chiefs of the tribes and performed by priests. Gods thus invoked in the sacrifice supposedly rewarded the sacrifice with success in wars, progeny, increase in cattle and long life. It also brought large number of gifts in the form of dana and dakshina in the priest. It is important here to note that during the entire Vedic phase, people did not construct temples nor did they worship any statue. These features of Indian religion developed much later. After many years it was developed. So we have already noted that in the later Vedic period, agriculture had become an important activity of people. Changes in the material life naturally resulted in change in their attitude towards gods and goddesses. Through continuous interaction with the local non-Aryan population also contributed to this change. Thus Vishnu and Rudra, which were smaller deities in the Rig Veda, became extremely important. However, we do not have any reference to difference in the incarnation or avatars of Vishnu. We are so familiar with it in any of later Vedic texts. Another important feature was the increase in the frequency and number of yajna, which generally ended with the sacrifice of a large number of animals. This was probably the result of the growing importance of the class of brahmanas and their efforts of maintaining their supremacy in the changing society. These yajnas brought to them a large amount of wealth in the form of dana and dakshini, and some of the important yajnas were Ashwamedha, Vajapeya, Rajasuya, etc. You must have heard about the yajnas in the stories of Mahabharata and Ramayana. In these yajnas, which continued for many days, a large part of gifts went to the brahmanas. The purpose of these yajnas was twofold. Firstly, it was to establish the authority of the chiefs over the people, and next is the reinforced the territorial aspect of polity, since people from all over the kingdom were invited for these sacrifices of the yajnas. You will find it interesting to know that the people began to oppose these sacrifices during the later Vedic period itself. A large number of cattle and other animals which were sacrificed at the end of each yajna must have hampered the growth of economy. Therefore, a path of God conducted and self-sacrifice was recommended for happiness and welfare in the lower sections of the Vedas, that called Upanishads. And the Upanishad contain two basic principles of Indian philosophy. One is karma and the transmigration of soul, rebirth based on the past deeds. According to these texts, the real happiness lies in getting moksha, freedom from the cycle of birth and rebirth. The early Vedic period, we have mentioned above that the chief social unit of the Aryans was known as Jana. The chief of this unit was the political leader called Rajan. The main function of the chief was to protect the Jana and cattle from the enemies. He was helped in his task by the tribal assemblies called Sabha, Samiti, Vidatha, Gana and Parishad. Out of these Sabha and Samiti were the most important assemblies. All aspects of life were discussed in these assemblies. These may include wars, distribution of the spoils of wars, judicial and legal activities. Thus, these assemblies in a way limited the power of chiefs. Interestingly, women were also allowed to participate in the deliberation of the Sabha and Samiti. The post of the chief was not hereditary. The tribes generally elected him, though the succession in one family was known. But that was not based on the rule of primogeniture. The Purohita assisted and advised the chief of various matters. Other than the Purohita, there were a limited number of other officials who assisted the chief in the day-to-day tribal affairs. Senani, Kulapa, Gramayani, etc. are some of the functionaries which find mention in the Rig Veda. The Sena or army was not a permanent fighter group and consisted of able-bodied tribesmen who were mobilized at the time of war. Stakshan, the carpenter, and Rathkara, the chariot maker, were responsible for making chariot. There is no official mentioned as collector of taxes. The people offered to chief was tis called Bali, and it was just a volunteer contribution made by the ordinary tribesmen on special occasion. All this shows that the early Vedic polity was an uncomplicated system. Changes in the later Vedic phase. The changes in the material and social life during the later Vedic period led to change in the political sphere as well. The nature of chiefship changed in the period. The territorial idea gained group. The people started to lose their control over the chief, and the popular assemblies gradually disappeared. The chiefship had become hereditary, and the idea of the divine nature of kingship gets a mention in the later literature of this period. The Brahmanas helped the chiefs in this process. The elaboration coronation rituals such as Vajpayee and Rajasuya established the chief authority. As the chiefs became more powerful, the authority of the popular assemblies started waning. The officers were appointed to help the chiefs in administration, and they acquired the functions of the popular assemblies as main advisory. The rudimentary army too emerged as an important element of the political structure during this period. All these lived on the taxes called Bali, the Shulka, and the Bhaga offered by the people. The chiefs of these people belong to the Kshatriya Varna, and they are legal with the Brahmanas. Try to establish complete control over the people in the name of Dharma. However, all these elements do not show that they Janapada or territorial states with all its attributes, such as the standing army and the bureaucracy, had emerged in the later Vedic period. But the process had started, and soon after the Vedic period, in 6th century BC, we notice the rise of 16 Mahajanapadas in the northern India. So okay friends, this was your chapter, the Vedic period or Vedic age. So okay friends, I will soon manage to explain another chapter. Till then, take care, have a nice day. Bye my dear friends.